The new EN5678 and EN5699 standards have brought many new changes and requirements, including the need for testing devices with floating inputs. Devices like desktop voltmeters, power analyzers, and oscilloscopes, or other similar devices that are usually found at educational institutions and laboratories. The new standards prescribe that these devices are tested using a three-step testing method, which is both cumbersome and time-consuming. However, there is an easier way, the Metrel way. Want to know more? Just continue watching. The Metrel way is the use of auto-sequences, which significantly speed up the testing process and greatly decrease the likelihood of errors. You're almost ready to start. Just don't forget to visually inspect the tested device before starting testing. Continuity of the protective conductor comes first, followed by the measurement of insulation resistance of the protective conductor to the neutral and face conductors. Now for the leakage current test. There are two test methods for leakage current testing on devices with floating inputs. One method entails the use of high voltages, while the other foregoes that for a three-step approach. The first step is evaluation of the protective conductor current without connecting the inputs through measuring the differential leakage current IDIF. The second step is evaluation of the protective conductor current as caused by the voltage used by the alternative leakage method, with connected floating inputs, of course. We are measuring the floating input leakage current, IFI. The final step, step 3, is merely the summation of total protective conductor current and the floating input leakage current, IDIF and IFI, in other words, the final result. And at the end, the functional test. Select the functional inspection test function and tick the appropriate boxes. That's it! Now on to the next job.